Hello students, welcome back to the physics class. Today we are continuing our third chapter, electromagnetic induction. In the previous class we already completed the AC generator. I hope you all understood that topic, and today we are going to learn about the another topic called mutual induction and transformer. So let's start the class. Okay, mutual induction. Here you can see a few turns of finely insulated copper wire are wound at each end of a soft iron core. The ends of one of the insulated copper wire are connected to a cell and a switch. The insulated copper wire, which is wound on the other end of the soft iron rod, is connected to a galvanometer. The first set of coil is called primary coil, and the second set of coil in the other end is called the secondary coil. When we turn on the switch of the primary coil, we can see the galvanometer in the secondary coil shows deflection to one side and come back to its original position. Then turn off the switch of the primary coil. At that time also, we can see the deflection of the galvanometer to the opposite direction. Here you can see the AC instead of DC in the primary coil and a 6 volt bulb in the secondary coil instead of galvanometer. When the switch is on, we can see the bulb glows continuously. So let's see what happens here when we using AC instead of DC. If AC is given to the primary coil instead of DC, EMF will be continuously induced in the secondary coil. When an AC passes through the primary, a varying magnetic field is formed in and around the soft iron core. The secondary is situated in this varying magnetic field. This situation is similar to the moving of a magnet inside the secondary coil. The flux change produced in the secondary coil induces an EMF in it. This phenomenon is the mutual induction. That is, through the primary coil, we give current for the production of magnetic field, and the induced EMF is generated in the secondary coil due to the flux change happens there. So let's see what is the definition of mutual induction. Consider two coils of wire kept side by side. When the strength or direction of the current in one coil changes, the magnetic flux around it changes. As a result, an EMF is induced in the secondary coil. This phenomenon is the mutual induction. So what is mutual induction? In the presence of a soft iron core, we have to keep two coils, primary coil and secondary coil, and the primary coil gives the current for the production of magnetic field, and the secondary coil produces the induced EMF due to the magnetic flux change. In mutual induction, there is a relation between the number of turns of the coil and the induced EMF. So let's see what is it. When the number of turns in the secondary increases, you can see in the figure, the intensity of bulb also increases here. That means the EMF increases. And when the number of turns in the secondary decreases, the intensity of bulb decreases. That means the EMF, induced EMF, decreases here. And the next one is transformer. So let's see what is a transformer. A transformer is a device that works on the principle of mutual induction. Transformer is a device for increasing or decreasing the voltage of an AC without any change in the electric power. Transformer consists of two coils, primary and secondary coil, and it is wound around a soft iron core. The AC current is given through the primary coil, and that is the input. And due to the magnetic flux change happens in this, the secondary coil produces induced EMF, and that is the output. the EMF in each turn of the primary and the secondary coils will be the same. That means the voltage in the primary is equal to the number of turns in the secondary into the EMF produced. And the induced EMF in the secondary is, that is Vs, it is equal to the number of turns in the secondary into the EMF produced there. Hence, Vs, that is the voltage in the secondary, changes in accordance with the number of turns in the secondary. The voltage in the secondary and primary will be in the same proportion as that between the number of turns of the secondary and primary. Transformers are of two types, step-up transformer and step-down transformer. So let's see what is a step-up transformer and step-down transformer. The one which increases AC voltage is step-up transformer, and which decreases AC voltage is a step-down transformer. Step-up transformer. In step-up transformer, thick wires are used in primary and thin wires are used in secondary, and the number of wire is less in primary than in secondary. In step-down transformer, thin wires are used in primary, thick wires are used in secondary. Number of wire is more in primary than in secondary. There is a relation between the number of turns and the induced EMF of a transformer, and this can be expressed by mathematically using the equation Vs by Vp equals Ns by Np, where Vs is the voltage in secondary, Vp is the voltage in primary, Ns is the number of turns in secondary, and Np is the number of turns in primary. The power in the primary and secondary coils of a transformer is the same. If there is no loss of power from a transformer, the power in the primary and the secondary coils will be equal. If voltage and current are known, what is the formula for finding power? Yes, power equals voltage into current. In a transformer, power in the primary is equal to power in the secondary. That is, Vp into Ip is equal to Vs into Is, where Vp and Ip are voltage and current in the primary, Vs and Is are voltage and current in the secondary. By rearranging this equation, we get Ip divided by Is equals Vs divided by Vp. In a step-up transformer, the voltage in the secondary coil is more and the current is less. But in a step-down transformer, the secondary voltage is less and the current is more. So that's about mutual induction and transformer. I hope you all understood this topic. Thank you for watching. See you in the next class.